you are mine, number 454.
Will change the weekend of November 26th and 27th. Mass at St. Agatha Church will be celebrated on Saturday at 6 p.m. and Mass at St. Luce Church will be celebrated on Sunday at 10:30 a.m. Beginning the weekend of November 26th and 27th, the minister's list will no longer be published in the bulletin. Please contact the Rectory Office at 543-7447 if you would like your list emailed or mailed to you. Lists will be also available in the church. The collection for the Catholic Campaign for Human Development was founded to end the cycle of poverty in the United States by funding organizations that help people help themselves. CCHD grants improve education, support economic development, and help communities provide housing in low-income neighborhoods. 25% of this collection will remain in Maine to support our parish ministries that make lasting changes in people's lives and uplift the poor living in our communities. Five of our parishes received approximately $15,000 for their ministries this past year. Please prayerfully consider your contribution to CCHD collection on the weekend of November 19 and 20 to help people right here in Maine. Next weekend, Father Jim has asked me to let you know that he will be staying a half an hour after all of the Masses in Our Lady of the Valley. For those of you who are here outside of Our Lady of the Valley, it doesn't concern you, but know that we have a capital campaign going on, and Father Jim will be here half an hour after all the Masses in Our Lady of the Valley as a, kind of an open forum for questions, question and answer time for anybody who has questions about the campaign itself. He wanted me to make sure that I let you know that these collections that we're doing for the campaign are for the safety in our churches, our three churches in Our Lady of the Valley. So if you have any questions about what's going on and what you can do and how you can help in other ways, maybe stay next week after Mass and Father Jim will answer your questions. Thank you. And at this time, like we always say, please turn off your cell phones. Thank you.
Conclusion of the Holy Year here at St. Luce and also throughout the churches in the world, the exception being St. Peter's in Rome, where the doors will be closed next Sunday. These doors, holy doors, have been given to us as an opportunity to enter into and to reflect more profoundly on the goodness of the Father, the deep mercy that Jesus has for us, and the ongoing work of the Holy Spirit in our lives. A gift that has been given to us that we in turn might grow in our own faith. Once again, we approach these sacred mysteries so that we can invoke together as God's people the blessings of our loving God and the mercy that brings healing and wholeness to our lives. You commend us to forgive one another before approaching your altar. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You invoke mercy upon sinners as you hung upon the cross. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You entrust the ministry of reconciliation to your church. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Healing rays, the word of the Lord.
Praise God.
But it will not immediately be the end. Then he said to them, Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be powerful earthquakes, famines, and plagues from place to place, and awesome sights and mighty signs will come from the sky. Before all this happens, however, they will seize and persecute you. They will hand you over to the synagogues and to prisons, and they will have you led before kings and governors because of my name. It will lead to your giving testimony. Remember, you are not to prepare your defense beforehand, for I myself shall give you a wisdom in speaking that all your adversaries will be powerless to resist or refute. You will even be handed over by parents, brothers, relatives, and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but not a hair on your head will be destroyed. By your perseverance, you will secure your lives. The Gospel of the Lord. Something I do once in a while in the parish that I work in is I sometimes begin with questions. I don't want to embarrass anyone, but just a show of hands, that's all I do, nothing not meant to be painful. But anyway, how many people here on Tuesday night probably went to bed later than they normally do? Just show of hands. I thought there'd be a few of you. And during the week, especially after the election, how many of you people did you listen to a program or maybe read an article about what will Donald Trump do? Now, this is the real hard question, and I'm not going to ask anyone to answer this question by showing their hands. But how many people have prayerfully prepared themselves for this Mass by reading the Gospel before coming to church? Many of us will read the Gospel either before Mass begins as a filler in. The election is going to come and go. But the Gospel has everything to do with our salvation. It's a gift from God. But it is a gift that you and I have got to work with. And the only way that we're going to be able to work with that gift is if we become familiar with it. Now, the greatest obstacles that we have is we've heard it before. And if you're 62 years old like me, there's nothing new to learn under the sun, right? So you hear what the Gospel story is saying today, and oh yes, Jesus is talking about the end of the world, and then we just check that off, and then we zone off into another space. Well, Jesus is talking about the end of the world, but Jesus is not talking about the end of the world. In chapter 17 of Luke's Gospel, Jesus does talk about the end of the world, but today, Jesus is in the holy city of Jerusalem. This is a journey that Jesus has been on since the beginning of summer. And for Jesus, his journey to Jerusalem has everything to do with being faithful to the Father. Which means, when Jesus gets to Jerusalem, his journey is not done, because it is a journey to the Father. And Jesus wants every one of his disciples also to be on that journey. To remember that we belong not to this world, but that we belong to God. And there are three things that Jesus says in the Gospel that you and I have got to remember over and over and over
until the day that we meet God face to face. Jesus begins by saying to his disciples, if he's speaking to the church, that you and I do not be deceived. And the reason that Jesus says that is there are a lot of voices in this world, and for some of us, there's a lot of voices within us. And you and I can be exhausted at the end of the day by listening to all of those voices. This is the first year that I'm aware of that people have been talking about this election for so long. And a question that people would ask before the election, they're still asking me. I was asked this morning. I was going out for breakfast. What do you think about this election? And we're all over the place. And Jesus says, do not be deceived. He is inviting us to make his voice the one that we listen to at all times. The problem in listening to the voice of Jesus is that Jesus is extremely demanding. He's very friendly. He's useful. But he's also very demanding. Because if you pay attention to the gospel, Jesus is not talking about the end of the world. He's talking about Christians being persecuted. So you and I need to listen to the voice of Jesus to be faithful to the Master. But we also need to understand that in our moments of confusion and in our moments of great difficulties and in our moments that we're filled with fear, we are also called to give witness. That you and I are the ones that have to be the voice of Jesus in our world today. And that's always meant to be good for our brothers and sisters. Now remember, Jesus is in Jerusalem. Jesus knows what's going to happen to him in Jerusalem. It's the events that we celebrate during Holy Week. Every one of the disciples has told Jesus, I will never abandon you. And yet the night that Jesus is arrested, he finds himself alone. And that's why for Jesus, it's so important for you and I to understand that it's not just a question of being able to receive, but we're also called to be witnesses, to share, to be a blessing for others. And then Jesus continues that you and I are not to worry, and that he's going to give us a wisdom. And we have to remember that the wisdom of Jesus has everything to do with the cross. That the wisdom of Jesus has everything to do with being a servant of God, but also a servant of all peoples. That the wisdom of Jesus has everything to do with dying to oneself so that we can be fully alive in God. The wisdom of Jesus is all about the cross, the way of the cross that we are called to internalize, but the way of the cross that we are called to make real for our brothers and sisters. Earlier this week, we had the feast, the celebration of the dedication of St. John Lateran in Rome. And the second reading of that day in the liturgy book is a writing that was taken from St. Augustine. And St. Augustine talks about, we enter the church, he was talking about the church building, we enter the church building so as to enter into the heart of God. But we only enter the heart of God when we allow God to enter our own hearts. And that's why the year of mercy, this jubilee that has been given to us, an emphasis on the holy doors, is to remember that. We enter into the heart of God, but more importantly, we want God to enter into our hearts and to find his dwelling there. The wisdom of Jesus requires that we be good with the spiritual and corporal works of mercy, that we remember that our lives are not about us, but it is about God, and the things that you and I are able to do to witness to the Lordship of Jesus. What we do this evening is a Mass of Thanksgiving for the great privilege that has been given to this church. And in this Mass of Thanksgiving, we acknowledge that yes, the Jubilee Year of Mercy is coming to an end. What does not come to an end is our walk with Jesus and our commitment to be with him at all times, which means we will be faithful to listening to his voice. We will allow ourselves to be his witnesses, and we will allow his wisdom to become the strength in our lives that becomes a blessing for our brothers and sisters. A way of life that is extremely demanding, but a life that always reflects the Father's mercy and love and brings us ever deeper into his loving heart. A place where we can fully experience all that God has for us and to truly be the person that our God wants us to be.
Together we make our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men, for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and he came back. For our sake he was crucified from on to high. He suffered death in the grave, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken from the heart. I believe in my Holy and Catholic and Catholic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I will flow into the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the Lord will come. Amen. We have listened to the word of God. We now ask God to listen to the words of prayer.
For the church, may we be ever vigilant in awaiting the coming of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That our newly elected leaders govern with wisdom, charity, and respect for the dignity of every citizen. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who are without shelter as the weather turns colder, for those without enough warm clothes, and for those who work outdoors in all kinds of weather, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That our faith community continue to proclaim and share God's mercy during this Jubilee Year of Mercy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have died, and also for Jean-Yves Saint-Pierre, for whom the intentions of this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Heavenly Father, you shower upon us all your goodness and love, and for this we are most grateful. Listen to our words of prayer, and be our strength that we might be faithful to you, who are always faithful to us. This we ask in the holy name of Jesus, for he is Lord, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our psalm is number 635, blessed are you. Number 635.
Accept, we pray, in mercy this sacrifice, which we offer you in thanksgiving, for our deliverance from evil. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty.
this command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. pray. Almighty God, who through this bread of life are pleased to free your servants from the bond of sin, and in your compassion to restore their strength, grant us to advance without hindrance towards the hope of glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My friends, let us joyfully thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Throughout this year of grace, he has bestowed on us every heavenly blessing in Christ. He has given us this precious time of mercy and conversion. Let us express our thanks and joy in the words of Elizabeth spoken to the Virgin Mary, our mother, as we sing the Lord's mercy extending to every generation. Let us ask him to pour out like the morning dewfall that same mercy throughout the entire world.
Our song's number 711, Hail Mary, Gentle Woman.
The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain. remain with you forever.
Amen.
Be merciful as our Heavenly Father is merciful. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And our song is How Great Thou Art, number 420. We'll sing verses 1 and 4.